farmhouse looking for a place to stay. I was mighty, mighty tired. I had come a long, long way. I said, hey, hey, in there, is anybody home? I was standing on the steps and feeling most alone. When out comes a farmer, he must have thought that I was nuts. He took one look at me and stuck a gun into my guts. I fell down upon my bended knees, and I dig, farmers, don't shoot me, please. He cocked his rifle and began to shout, you're that traveling salesman that I've heard so much about. I said, no, 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 I'm a doctor and it's true. I'm a clean-cut kid and I've been to college too. Just then comes his daughter, whose name was Rita. She looked like she stepped out of the Dolce Vita. I immediately tried to cool it with her dad. I told him what a nice pretty farm I thought he had. He said, what do doctors know about farms, pray tell? I said, I was born at the bottom of a wishing well. Well, by the dirt beneath my nails, I guess he knew I wouldn't lie. He said, I guess you're tired. He said it kind of sly. I said, yes, 10,000 miles today I drove. Well, I got a bed for you underneath the stove. Just one condition, you'll go to sleep right now, that you don't touch my daughter, and in the morning you milk the cow. I was sleeping like a rat when I heard something jerking. Mr. Rita looking just like Tony Perkins. She said, would you like to take a shower? I'll show you up to the door. I said, no, 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 I've been through this before. I knew I had to split, but I did not know how. When she said, would you like to take that shower now? But I couldn't leave unless the old man turned me out. See, it was already promised that I'd milk his cow. I had to say something to strike him most weird. I like Fidel Castro and his beard. Well, Rita looked offended, but she got out of the way when he came charging down the steps, saying, was that I heard you say? I said, I like Fidel Castro, I believe you heard me right. And I ducked as he swung at me with all his might. Rita mumbled something about her mother on the hill. His fist hit the icebox, he said he's gonna kill me if I don't get out the door in 2 seconds flat. You unpatriotic, rotten doctor, commie rat. He threw a Reader's Digest at my head and I did run. I did a somersault as I seen him get his gun. And I crashed through the window at 100 miles an hour. And I landed fully flush in the garden flowers. Rita said, come back, as he started to load. The sun was coming up as I was running down the road. But how many roads will a man run down before they stop calling him a man anyhow? And how many times will a man turn his head till he sees the real head turner in the end will be his death? And how many deaths will it take till Rita knows it's time she puts away that frock, the granny wig, and the pantyhose? Still, I don't figure I'll be going back for a spell. Though Rita moved away and got a job at a motel. He still waits for me, eagle-eyed night and day. He's looking for a job at the NSA. Me, I romp and stomp, grateful as I romp without freedom of speech, I might be in the swamp. Thank you.